Hello, everyone. Welcome to my portion of this evening's festivities. I'm going to be recognizing musicians from our instrumental band side want to extend, first off, how absolutely grateful and how proud I am of these students. This has been the most bizarre year and a half of education for any students that I could possibly imagine. These students have been with us for 4 years and have worked through a lot of rehearsals, a lot of sweat, a lot of heart, and a lot of soul. And I'm grateful for all the work and all the heart that you've brought to your music at Churchill High School. These are students that I'm recognizing tonight who I think will leave a legacy. They're the kind of student that when you walk in the band room, you look up to see what they do, and that's what you try to emulate. So I'm grateful to these students, and want to thank you for the joy of making music, which is ultimately to me what this is all about. And thank you for your heart, your soul, your creativity, and your dedication to Lancer Band. So this first set of awards is an award that is given on behalf of a man named Vondis Miller. Vondis Miller was the director of bands at Churchill High School from 1967 to 1965. Vondis was extremely dedicated to spreading music to his students and spreading music to other music educators. He realized somewhere in his existence it was important that not only do students need to learn music, but he was very instrumental in seeing that other music educators were trained properly. So very dedicated. Vondis taught at Churchill till 1975. He moved to Canada and was with two universities in Canada, started a legendary wind group known as the Calgary Winds. And after his retirement, Vondis taught in Tucson, Arizona. He taught a combination of students from an Indian tribe in Arizona and students who were children of migrant farm workers. And to me, what a fantastic dedication, dedicating his life in his retirement to seeing that students, no matter what their situation, were able to access music and play instruments. In fact, it's very likely that the morning that he passed away, he had taught band either the day before or that morning. So extremely dedicated man to spreading band to students. So in recognition of his hard work, this certificate reads like this: for outstanding work and contribution to the Churchill High School Band, in the spirit of Vondis Kasdan Miller, Churchill High School Director of Bands 1967 to 1975, I'd like to recognize the following individuals. This first student, fantastic jazz musician, great individual, and someone who's really embodies what it is it means to work hard in rehearsal, work hard in performance, and be good to his fellow bandmates. This first recognition goes to Finn Juniman. Thunderous applause. Next award goes to a musician who worked very hard for 4 years, was also, I should mention, an outstanding music technician in the music technology area, and I think should be recognized for his work there as well. So this individual is joined jazz band late in his 4 years at Churchill and became a very, very, very outstanding member of that band. This award goes to Jack Johnson. Thunderous applause. This next musician is one of the busiest individuals I know at Churchill High School in our arts department. And with all that was going on, this individual maintained a presence in jazz band and was a solid leader, solid player, and a very good musician who I'm happy to have had the chance to work with us. This goes to Asher Brewer. Okay, these next two members are just outstanding young musicians and have brought a lot of joy to making music at Churchill High School. Very dedicated band, not just symphonic band, wind ensemble, and but also wind ensemble, symphonic band, and jazz band. Wonderful musicians, wonderful people, and I have my gratitude and thanks for being so inspirational and having such great leadership skills. This first award, this goes to Andrea Webster Bernal. And my last Vondis Miller Award for outstanding work and contribution. This person is just an inspirational student, someone who worked very hard without even realizing it sometimes, being a leader, someone that other students looked to see how this all worked, and carried that responsibility and did a great job. Saw that band continued and was a great leader. This goes to Samantha Webster Bernal. Okay, everyone. Here are two awards that are kind of the finale to my year. And before I give those out, I want to say again, thank you to everybody. Having stuck it out through the last year and a half of bizarro world education, I'm happy that these students felt strongly enough about their instrumental education to continue. We've made some interesting music together. We have played some interesting pieces, and at the same time survived one of the most bizarre things that's ever happened. So my grateful thanks for all of your heart and soul again. All right, this two awards, these are given by the National Association for Music Education, which is kind of the guiding overall music education organization that many, 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 many music teachers belong to. And they give these awards. You're allowed one per band program. And it's one of the hardest decisions I get to make. All of our seniors this year are outstanding people, outstanding musicians. And it's always the hardest thing I have to do is to figure out who I think has demonstrated these skills to the high, into such a high level. So the first award that I want to give is the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award in recognition of outstanding achievements in the field of jazz as demonstrated through superior musicianship, character, individual creativity, the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award is hereby presented to an individual who has never once turned down the opportunity to make music, turned down the opportunity to play, turned down the opportunity to take a solo. There's a willingness to put it out there from this student that I admire and respect. This student has been involved in wind ensemble, been involved in jazz band, been involved in jazz workshop, been involved in conducting, and has been an inspiration to many, many, many students. This is another one of those musicians who people look to, whether this person knew it or not, look to see how this works and how all this happens. So I'm very, very proud and very, very happy to give this award to Michael Liner. Okay. And this award, again, I agonize over making this decision, but I know I've made the right decision when I'm at rest with who I've chosen, and happy to award this. This is the John Philip Sousa Band Award. I received this in the spring of 1983 and have felt that connection to everyone I've given this this award to. It was inspirational to me, and I was very grateful to receive that award because I knew the depth of what it meant. This award means a lot. This and I read this so that you can understand the frame of mind that I had when picking this individual. This is given the John Philip Sousa Band Award, and it reads, in recognition of outstanding achievement and interest in instrumental music, for singular merit in loyalty, cooperation, and for displaying those high qualities of conduct that school instrumental music requires. I love the loyalty, cooperation, and for displaying those high qualities of conduct. This individual has touched everyone he's worked with in Churchill High School band greatly. I've said it a million times and I'll say it a million times that when you mention this student's name, the first response from everybody is instantly, oh, I love that guy. Oh, I love that guy. I can honestly say that this student has touched my life as well. I'm grateful for the opportunity to have worked with this student. And I am amazed every day in band that with what the student is capable of, his understanding of music, his willingness to always play and always play to the best of his ability. I'm also have been amazed for 4 years watching this person touch everybody he's met. I'm sorry that it's been so strange the last year, but even over a Zoom class meeting, this person is absolutely outgoing and just exudes love and compassion and caringness for his individual musicians that he works with. So I am very happy, very proud, and very honored to have worked with this student for the last 4 years. And I'll read it this way. In recognition of outstanding achievement and interest in instrumental music, for singular merit in loyalty and cooperation, and for displaying those high qualities of conduct that school instrumental music requires, the John Philip Sousa Band Award is hereby presented to Theo Willis. Theo, from me and all your colleagues in Churchill High School Band, we love you. We're going to miss you. And I'm grateful for all the musicianship, all the heart, all the soul, and all the love that you have brought to 4 years of Churchill Band. Thank you, Theo. Hey, everyone. I wanted to take another second and announce this. These are chord recipients from the instrumental side of the West End Performing Arts Academy here at Churchill. These are students who have participated above and beyond for 4 years and have earned the honor at graduation of wearing a chord from our West End Academy. I want to thank these students for all their work and all their dedication to Churchill music. The following people receive these chords when at cap and gown pickup. And I'm proud of these individuals and again, grateful for the opportunity to work with them. The recipients this year are Miranda Barthay, Lillian Barwood, Asher Brewer, Melly DeStefano, Katie Hazen, Jack Johnson, Finn Juniman, Michael Liner, Sonia Nusser, Ian Miller, Jackson Perry, Marco Pena, Jim Steele, Tom Troberg, Andrea Webster Bernal, Samantha Webster Bernal, and Theo Willis. I thank you, and Churchill West End thanks you. Thank you, everybody. Happy summer. Get ready to work in the fall. We're going to get back at it and we're going to do what Churchill Band does best. Thanks, everybody.
Good evening and welcome to the choir portion of tonight's West End Awards ceremony. I'm Jacob Steinberger, and as we look back on the year and reflect on a pretty rough year, really. I mean, that is just so hard doing choir and music, or choir and band and drama online. And I just want to take a moment to just reflect on some of the things that we were able to do throughout this year, and then we will pay some specific recognition to some individuals. So throughout the course of the year, we were able to rehearse all of our music completely on Zoom, a one-way thing where I'm playing piano and the singers are reading their music on their end, and then they're singing along with really nobody except for me at times. And that is just tough, and that takes a lot of individual drive and determination to be able to do that and to stick with it. But through that, we actually were able to do a winter concert where we performed many different songs, and we heard solos and a lot of different virtual recordings that students did through a program called Soundtrap. That was in the winter, and that was a big build up to that, and then kind of a wow, look what we did. That was really fun. And then winter set in, and then it was okay, this is still happening. We're still doing this. We are in our 13th week of this, and it was laborsome. But the students pulled through. In the winter, our Downing Street Singers were able to do a festival with the DeMiro Jazz Festival, where students put on two different virtual choir performances and got to have experiences with professionals in the field of jazz. And we got to watch specifically tailored videos to topics of jazz that were made just for that festival. And we also had a clinician come and work with us, the fabulous Rosanna Eckert. And she came in and worked with our group and talked to us about music and our craft and all things jazz. And then that festival culminated with a couple of virtual choir performances by our students, along with other students around the country. So that was kind of a cool thing to be able to do that with others that wouldn't normally attend that festival. Then we moved into hybrid, where we were in school and divided into cohorts. And some of our singers had to switch voice parts to balance some of those cohorts, since the entire group was really never there at one time, except near the very end. And that was challenging, but it was so awesome to be able to hear people sing again. And it was super, super encouraging. And just the whole energy in the room was so much more vibrant. And I didn't have to talk to a screen, and the students didn't have to feel like they were just watching YouTube or a boring Netflix show. So with that, though, we were actually able to put together some performances that I'd like to invite you all to watch this coming Friday. We put together kind of an offering of different performances that all three of our ensembles did throughout the spring term. So we invite you to come to that. I'll be posting a link to that on the Churchill website and also emailing it out to people. So that'll be Friday at 6:30 as well. So stay tuned. I think that will be the final Churchill event. So that'll be fun. All right, and as we move into the awards portion of tonight, which is that's why we're all here, I would like to first just honor and recognize our fabulous choir council for their hard work. And that's really just a job that when there's not a lot of external motivation of being in class and being around the people in person. Yeah, it just takes a lot for students to remain motivated in order to do things for other students to keep them involved. So I just want to do a quick shout out here to some individuals in the choir council. We had Julia Roloff was our treble choir representative. We had Vivian Tritch and Stephanie Sterling as our alto section leader representatives. Rowan Lovering as soprano section leader. Bobby Davis as bass section leader, and Rogan D. Calesta as tenor section leader and choir president. And then our wonderful Stefan, excuse me, Eden Stefan, for being our PR manager and posting all the things on Instagram. We just really appreciate your work with that, Eden. Thank you. And so thank you to Choir Council for helping me run things smoother than they would have been run. And so, round of applause for them. Okay, so our first big award for the night, we have three of them that I'm giving out, and those are the plaque awards. These awards hang on the walls in the Churchill Choir Room, and people can come back and see the recipients' names and/or pictures on the wall forevermore. So the first award is the Director's Award. And this award right here will, it's a plaque that will have the students' names. And this award goes out to individuals that have gone above and beyond with anything that has to do with helping the director and being there for the choir and just being an eager helper and somebody that just really helps boost the choir program in a kind of behind the scenes way. The first recipient of this, we're actually going to give out two director's awards. And the first recipient of this is a student that is majorly involved in theater and choir in West End and has done amazing things in both. But particularly for choir, this person has been kind of just that silent behind the scenes leader that waits for the director to just ask one little thing of like, hey, could you take care of that? Or could you lead your section and help them with this? And that person, once they have kind of the green light for that, they just go. And they're awesome at what they do. They've helped so much with sectional work and especially this last section sing-off. Students were just kind of blown away at the director, the director skills that this person has. They're a fine musician, a wonderful singer, and are going to be going into the performing arts after high school. And I'm just going to miss this person so much. They are also just an amazing person. So sweet and just so kind, and such a good mentor and somebody to look up to for younger students. The first recipient of the Director's Award is Rowan Lovering. Congratulations, Rowan. Round of applause. All right, now the second recipient of the Director's Award is somebody that their work is a little more visible, I would say, very visible to people outside of the choir program and in the choir program. This person has done countless different video projects throughout the year. We couldn't have done the winter concert without this person. We couldn't actually be doing the West End Awards right now, probably without this person, or they wouldn't be as good. And if I'm thinking back in years past, this person has put together numerous different choir commercials and been the person that films it and comes up with the concept and conceives it and makes it and turns it into life. Some of the topics for it, really funny choir commercials, were an office themed choir commercial, and those commercials obviously are to advertise getting students to join choir. Office themed commercial, and then they also did this really great insurance package commercial with the different choir bundles. And just some really cool stuff. And they are actually going on to do that very thing in film school after high school. And I just appreciate this person so, so much for all the work that they've done. Again, another amazing human being who is so kind, so thoughtful. Just really, both of these individuals embody Churchill Choir and what we strive to be in it. And I couldn't be more proud of Vivian Tritch. Congratulations, Vivian, on receiving the Director's Award. Thank you. Thank you to both Rowan and Vivian. We wish you well. All right, now on to our next award of the three awards. And this award is called the Ella Fitzgerald Award. And here is what it looks like. And you can see some names and some people from years past on here. There's one recipient that I still need to put on here from last year. I have their picture. I just need to put it up there. But I left this year's recipient's picture off of here because of the suspense of it all. Wouldn't want to give it away. All right. So the Ella Fitzgerald Award goes to an individual who exhibits the highest vocal ability and the highest level of their craft. And in particular, this has to do with multiple different genres, but especially in the genre of jazz. Ella Fitzgerald obviously was an iconic pioneer of vocal jazz. And so that is why this award is named after her. And this person, you know, just like all the seniors, I wish that I had one more year with this person, because in the realm of jazz, I feel like their time and other people's time, everybody's time, has been cut short for opportunities to sing more jazz. But if we think back to the live times, this person was getting a grasp on different types of improvisation, was already a really strong singer and somebody who can just kind of just take the stage and blow you away with their skills in singing. And throughout this year, this person also was just hungry for learning more about jazz and about singing, and they have just been such a pleasure to work with. Again, another incredibly sweet person, kind, caring, not self-absorbed, very much about the we and not the me. And I just appreciate them so much, just like all the award winners. But that person, this year's Ella Fitzgerald Vocal Jazz Award, goes to Stephanie Sterling. Congratulations, Stephanie. Round of applause. And I can't believe it, the final award that is going to be given tonight for the choir portion of our awards is an award called the National School Choral Award. This award goes to an individual who is completely outstanding in all areas of the choir program. The actual certificate here reads that the National School Choral Award is in recognition of singular merit, ability, and achievement of outstanding contributions to the success of the school vocal program, and of an unusual degree of loyalty, cooperation, and high qualities of conduct by the general consent of the music faculty, school officials, and others. I think that's a great summarization of this award, and I think that this year's recipient hands down embodies that. This person has been in choir all 4 years, in concert choir all 4 years, has in concert choir, has become a section leader, was a section leader early on and did it for multiple years, and was on choir council, and then ultimately became the choir president for the last, choir president for the last 2 years. This person is hardworking. They are vocally talented, a great musician, very good reader, team player. They have an ability to rally people together and to have like a sense of unity in the group. And then at the end of the week, they always do the Macarena with the group. I will miss this person so much, but I know and am confident that they are going to go on and do wonderful things with their career and in music and in theater as well. The National School Choral Award goes to Rogan DiColesta. Congratulations, Rogan. All right, and that concludes the choral portion of the show, and I am now going to pass it off But before that, I just want to say again to all of our participants in choir this year, thank you so much for your dedication, your hard work, and your heart towards things, and just persevering. This was a really tough year, and I am so excited to see you reaching out to your friends and encouraging them to do choir next year. And I'm just excited to see what you do in choir next year as you go on to new things. Thank you so much, and have a good evening.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to drama's portion of the West End Awards 2021. Let's get to it. First, we have a really amazing group of freshmen that worked with us on Clue this year, and that is Claire, Jory, Brooklyn, and Anna. They did absolutely amazing, and I am so proud of the work that they did. Debut of the year goes to Sierra Taylor, Cheyenne Menenga, and Julia Roloff. These three had their first big show on the Churchill stage this year. I'm so proud of the work that they did. Sierra and Julia, I can't wait to work with you next year. And Cheyenne, I'm so happy we finally got you into a play. You did wonderful. Good luck in your future endeavors. For best sound design, it hurts my soul to say this, the last time we see these two in the Thespian Awards, last time I get to work with both of them, Jack Johnson, Katie Hazen, seniors graduating this year. I'm gonna miss you both so much. Any of the music that you heard this year in any of our shows was actually made by Jack Johnson, so check out his SoundCloud, and y'all did wonderful. Next, we have the Sus Award. Tyga Hadwin, put together almost all on his own an entire ad campaign for our show of Clue. He put together a game of Among Us with a bunch of the students, edited a video. It was wonderful, and Tyga, you did a great job. The Comedic Gold Award goes to Jade Carson. Typos are hard, guys. Typos are hard. All right, goes to Jade Carson. Jade gets this award because over and over and over and over, Jade made me laugh this year. Especially with her role of Mrs. Peacock in Clue. Just absolutely hilarious and great work. Best Dressed Awards goes to Ruth Ann Wilson, the Lord of the costume department. Ruthie, it's been amazing to work with you 4 years. We're gonna miss you next year, and thanks for everything you've done. Eleanor West gets the Elocution Award. Eleanor had some of the most difficult lines to deliver this year, and he did so amazingly. His role of Dogberry, you wouldn't guess it, but a lot of those words are wrong on purpose, and it takes some skill to make it look like not an accident. So great job, Eleanor. The Theodore Patton Award for Excellence goes to Rogan DeCalesta, for many reasons. The amount of roles that he's done at Churchill have been absolutely amazing. He's been one of the backbones of the theater program since I took over, and he's just done some really, really great work. Next, we have Excellence in Editing, and this award goes to Vivian Tritch. We had to go all online, all digital this year, and that would not have been possible without the amazing video editing work of Vivian. That actually includes the West End Awards, edited by Vivian as well. Vivian, thank you for everything you've done for the drama program here at Churchill. I'm definitely going to miss you. The Nessajean Patton Award for Excellence goes to Michael Leiner. Michael has been a solid rock in the costuming department the entire time that he's been at Churchill. He had an amazing turn in Much Ado About Nothing, and from what I hear, is a quite the brass player as well. So the Nessajean Patton Award for Excellence goes to Michael Leiner. Outstanding contribution to technical theater goes to none other than Asher Brewer. Asher, you have been my stage manager for the last 2 years, assistant stage manager for 2 years before that. It's a joy to work with you. I'm really going to miss you next year. Words are escaping me just how much I value you as a person and your contributions to this program. Backstage is going to be a very different place without you next year. So thank you for everything from the bottom of my heart. Finally, the Outstanding Thespian Award goes to none other than Rowan Lovering. Rowan, I think for the last 4 years, you have been the heart and soul of this program. We wouldn't be where we are today without you. We would never have one state without you. I feel a little bit like shows wouldn't have happened this year without you. And there will always be, I will always remember you. You know, there are students that stay with you for your entire life. And Rowan, you're one of them. Go out there, go be amazing, and thank you for everything. I have a couple special thanks I'd like to give. First to M. Martini. M stepped in a couple times this year to help us out when some roles fell through. So M, thank you so much for kind of just being available and being wonderful you. I have three parents, Sandy Bybee, Hildy Tritch, and Pam DeCalesta. These three have been with me the last 4 years helping out at Churchill, and I know that our shows would not have been as good as they were without those three. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much for everything that you've done. Your devotion to this program, to your children, to other people's children, has been just a beautiful thing to witness. And if any of you ever try to buy a ticket to any future show, you will not be allowed. Your names will be on a list. Do not ever try, because you don't pay a dollar when you come to the theater, because you help build this program. Finally, the graduating seniors. This is a special group this year. You all were freshmen in my first year doing theater here full-time, taking over full-time at Churchill. You kind of grew up with me, just thank you so much for being you. Each and every one of you is just an amazing human being. It breaks my heart that this is how things ended, but know that you are powerful, strong, artistic, intelligent, amazing young people, and I can't wait to hear about all of the awesome things that you've done. So thank you all. And finally, I have one more thing that I need to say. As many of you know, our wonderful Jacob Steinberger is moving on to a different school next year, and I thought I would just express a little bit of how I feel about that. Jacob, you have been just an absolutely wonderful partner to work with, and you made this job so much fun and so enjoyable. I'm going to miss coming into the choir and saying hi. I'm going to miss coming into your office and just lying on your couch and complaining about whatever's going on, and you just being this solid rock of support. I wish you all the best as you go on to your new endeavors, and Don't forget to buy a couple tickets and come see the shows. I love you, man.